Filipino House lawmakers are looking to file a bill to ban pogo operations in the country and repeal the law taxing offshore gaming operators. According to party list Representative Franz Castro, their House bill will also set penalties for officials involved in the pogo business. For Kabataan Party List Congressman Raul Manuel, the long-term risks of hosting pogos outweigh its supposed economic benefits. Manuel also believes pogos have become a front for criminal activities.
Anhin ba naman natin ang pangako ng mga pogo na trabaho or economic development di umano sa mga lugar na nag-host niyan. Kung binubukas naman ang bansa natin sa mga hindi kaaya-ayang aktibidad na nangyayari sa mga pogo na iyan.
Laging kanlungan taloy tayo ng mga kriminalidad, no? At ito ay nagbunga ito ng mga anti-social activity, na mga krimen, mga paglabag sa batas, mga human rights violations. Sa ngayon, sa impormasyon natin, more than 400 plus pa na mga pogo. So kagaya na sinabi ni Kong Raul, dapat ito ay ban na talaga. Tanggalin na lahat itong mga pogo na ito. At wala itong dapat na pinipili.
Philippine authorities report nearly 10 billion pesos worth of damage to agriculture in the aftermath of El Nino. But the Agriculture Department said Friday that amount was below what it had expected owing to preparations by the government. The rice sector took on the biggest hit. The agency, however, remains hopeful of meeting its rice production target of 20 million metric tons this year. The government's focus now turns to the La Niña, or the weather phenomenon characterized by excessive rainfall.
Sa ngayon ay marami ring mga programa, lalo na sa water management intervention, paghahanda natin para sa La Niña, at yung pagbibigay pa rin natin ng mga angkop na teknolohiya sa binhi, sa pataba, sa irigasyon, sa makinarya, at lahat ito ay nakakatulong para mas lalo nating maabot yung additional na target natin for this year.
Residents of five villages in the municipality of La Castellana in Negros Occidental evacuate amid the threat of lahar following the eruption of Mount Canlaon. Now, this comes after recent heavy rains raised fears of mud flows that could put several villages on its path in danger. The affected villages are Biak na Bato, Kapagdaan, Upper Masulog, Mansalanao, and Sagang. Local officials say they have opened more evacuation centers to accommodate affected residents. So far, more than 700 families have been displaced. The eruption has so far caused nearly 10 million pesos in damage to agriculture in Negros Occidental.
Over in Batangas, residents living near Taal Volcano are advised to mask up due to the volcanic smog caused by the continuous degassing activity in its main crater. Hazy conditions were reported in towns around Taal Volcano, including Alitagtag, Tingloy, San Nicolas, and Batangas City. According to FEVOC's director, Teresito Bacolcol, areas near Taal should expect fog to persist amid weak wind conditions. Residents are also advised to keep windows closed and avoid staying outdoors. Local disaster officials say it is safe for tourists to visit Batangas.